In this video, I'll demonstrate how to solve the laboratory exercise Router and Switch Resilience of the course Cybersecurity Essentials from Cisco, and will hardening the iOS configuration and activating the Cisco iOS Resilience configuration feature. But before start doing the exercise, subscribe to the channel not to miss more videos about Packet Tracer, networking and Cisco courses. Hit the like button if this video helped you, and comment if you have any questions about Packet Tracer and this exercise. Let's start doing the exercise. You should open the Network Metropolis Bank, open the computer of Sally, open the desktop and the command prompt. And now we'll remote connect to the router. This is the router with the IP 10.44.1.1. So we'll connect via SSH. So write the command SSH minus L. The username is admin and the IP 10.44.1.1. Enter. It asks for the password, that is Cisco 12345. Enter. And we are on the router. We can see that we didn't got any warning, any message when we entered the router. And we should have a warning message preventing unauthorized users from accessing the router. So let's do that. Let's create a legal notification message on the router. Enter the command enable. The password is class. Now enter configuration mode. Right. Configure terminal. We are on config mode. Now you should get the message your teacher gave you. This is a command for a banner of MOTD, so message of the day. Copy the message and paste it. This will enter all the lines of the message for the message of the day. Let's check if this worked. So end the config mode with the command end log out. So we are logged out of the router, we are on the computer. Let's again try to SSH to the router with the password Cisco 12345. And now we have a warning message when we access this router. A warning saying unauthorized access to this device is prohibited, and the rest of the legal information. So this was the first step to configure this router. Now let's enforce password security on the router. So right, enable the password class, enter the config mode with the command configure terminal. We are on config mode, and now we'll encrypt plain text passwords in running config. So write the command service password dash encryption. And to enforce any new configured passwords to have a minimum of 10 characters, write the command security passwords min dash length space 10. Now the passwords are encrypted and they need to have at least 10 characters. So the router is more secure now. And now the next part is activating the Cisco iOS Resilient configuration feature. Let's start to check the iOS image. So exit config mode and write dir flash. You can see the first file is a bin file. This is the current iOS image. So we'll enter the configure mode. So configure terminal. And first we'll secure the boot image. This will activate iOS image resilience and prevent the iOS file from both showing in the directory output and prevents the deletion of the secure iOS file. So write the command secure space boot dash image. and enter. And we got the message, successfully secured running image. So our iOS image of the router is secured. Now let's store a secure copy of the running configuration to prevent the deletion of the secured configuration file. So write the command secure space boot dash config and enter. And we got the message successfully secured config archive. That is this file .ar file. Let's see if these configurations worked. So let's exit config mode, write exit, enter, and dir flash. We no longer see the .bin image, the iOS image we saw earlier, but the image exists. To view the status of the Cisco iOS image and configuration resilience, write the command show secure boot set and enter. And we can see that we have an iOS image resilience, and this is the file, that bin file, and we have an iOS configuration resilience .ar file. So both the iOS image and the iOS configuration is secure on this router. And this is everything you had to do to complete this exercise. Now subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos about Packet Tracer, networking and Cisco courses. Hit the like button if this video helped you, and write in the comments if you have any questions about Packet Tracer, about this exercise, networking or Cisco courses. And I will see you on the next video.